My video about this thing got more than 3 million views on Instagram and YouTube, and a lot of questions. So today it's finally time to explain what the strange mechanism actually is and how it works. It's a gearbox that can be used in robotics to reduce a motor speed and increase its torque. It looks like a cycloidal drive, but flipped inside out. Cycloidal drives are very precise, used in robotics and really popular in the DIY community, because they can be easily 3D printed. I really like the idea of that smart wavy profile engaging with the pins, but I'm not a big fan of the eccentric pinhole coupling used to transfer the torque. You have to match the bearings or bushings to the pin diameter to compensate for the eccentricity. And without bearings, plastic holes can handle high torque. So I'm always searching for ways to simplify this design for 3D printing. One of them is wave drive with rolling elements, which I already made a video about. But this one is different, and honestly this is the simplest cycloidal gearbox I've ever built. But it wasn't that easy to design. Luckily, Bambu Lab sent me their new H2S printer. My first Bambu was the A1, and that already felt like a whole new level of usability. But this one is the next step. Just look at this massive build volume. You might ask, why would you even need that much space? Well, I like printing parts in different colors to highlight the components, and to avoid wasteful purging, I use the print by object feature all the time. It needs some space around the parts, so a bigger build area really helps. Overall, more space speeds up prototyping, especially on larger projects, and I'm going to start building a robotic arm soon. Now I can finally print with engineering filaments like PHTCF. It's great, for example, for a motor mount because it can handle heat from the motor. I'm also really impressed with the new AMS2 Pro. Drying filaments right inside the unit helps a lot, because humidity here on the island is no joke. And since I print a lot of gears and accuracy matters to me, I also got the vision encoder plate, just to keep the printer precise over time. So yeah, I'm super happy with the new H2S. It gives very consistent print results and helps me prototype faster, so I can focus on the project, not on the printing. The idea of this drive came one night when Ben from Morse Dynamics sent me a video of this Chinese industrial reducer used in mining and heavy lifting machinery. By the way, you should definitely check out Ben's Instagram if you haven't already. I really like this reducer for its inside-out eccentric gear design, and that the input shaft is located outside of the output gear, which opens up a lot of design possibilities. I lost my sleep and started thinking that I can make a small 3D printable version with a cycloidal profile. I'm terrible at sketching, so I jumped straight into CAD. The gear profile is based on a cycloidal drive but flipped inside out. Normally a cycloidal drive uses a hypocycloid curve, but here I'm using an epicycloid one, because the pins engage along the outer diameter. It's a feature script for Onshape, and I also made an open source script in Python with export to DXF. I'll share the links down below. My first version had two plates positioned 180 degrees out of phase for balance, and to work properly the plate should have a parallel motion. I threw all the parts into the printer and put together the first prototype. And yeah, it jammed. It happens at the points where the plates lined up in a straight line. And I think that's because a parallel motion linkage with independent shafts has a singularity. Let me show you what I mean. As you can see, we have these independent red side links that represent our eccentric shafts, one driving and one driven. And a blue rod that moves parallel to the base. But when the rod becomes aligned with the base, the driven link no longer knows which way it should rotate, and it can flip the wrong way, breaking the parallel motion linkage. If we add a second rod on the opposite side, the whole mechanism locks up. Plastic parts and small backlash make this effect even worse. Only when both shafts rotate in sync, it can overcome this singularity. So I tried to add a timing bell to synchronize the camshafts. It helped a little, but come on, that's not a simple gearbox anymore. Another option is to place a second rod at a different angle, like 90 or 120 degrees, and then they actually start covering each other. So you just need to add a third rod to balance everything. If I were a bit smarter, I'd probably have googled this Chinese reducer first, and its name, the Three Ring Drive. Makes sense, right? It reminded me of three-phase motors and three-phase electrical system. So I decided to stop overthinking and just copy this design. But who wants to use this gearbox with an eccentric shafts on opposite sides? It's bulky and not really suitable for compact robots. And I saw that they also have a single input shaft design. So I just removed one eccentric shaft to see how it performs. It looked like it wouldn't work, and it really doesn't, until you install all three plates. Only then the plates start supporting each other and keep the output shaft rotating in one direction. So now I have a single input shaft design. Then I noticed that it still had some torque ripple. At first I thought it was just a quirk of kinematics of the single shaft design. I even tried a double eccentric shaft variant, but nothing changed. Then I found where the issue came from. As you can see, the plates shift slightly sideways, and sometimes they even touch the housing. That's when the torque drops. The plastic just isn't rigid enough. We could fix it by making the plates thicker, but there are three of them, and we want to keep the gearbox as slim and compact as possible. So I wedded a steel ball bearings between the plates and the housing to keep equal spacing. And after that, it started spinning like butter. Finally. I've been getting much better with Onshape and made this very configurable model that generates all the internal components, as well as an envelope that defines the clearance you need to cut out from the housing. There are lots of parameters you can adjust to fit your project, you'll find the link to the model down below. A bit later in this video we'll build a 2-axis wrist prototype, but right now I'll put together the test gearbox so we can measure the torque. I've put a lot of effort into this video and the gearbox design, so I'd really appreciate a shout out if you use it in your project. I'm generally curious to see what people might build with it. This gearbox has 20-to-1 gear ratio, and to drive it I'm using a DYS4108 PLDC motor and the Motios controller. Actually, it would work great in a quadruped robot. Okay, I should print it with a different filament. It showed 6.1 Nm torque with 25 amps current limit. And it skipped on 9.8 Nm. These 5mm plates are printed with PLA. So let's push it to the limit and make the longest gearbox my printer can fit. It has the same 20-to-1 gear ratio and settings as the previous one. And it spins surprisingly well. I have no idea why, but the torque is actually higher, about 6.5 Newton meters. I expected it to be less efficient with the same settings. But the maximum torque is much lower because the PLA plates flex and the gearbox starts skipping. Sadly, this torque adapter isn't sensitive enough to measure the motor on its own, and I also broke my scale. But I have my own efficiency test, and look how easily it spins. Just kidding. This little guy has 14:1 ratio, and I use it in a wrist assembly prototype, along with an angular roller pinion drive from my last video. I'm really proud of how this preloading screw turned out. For the pitch axis, I'm using 18:1 double eccentric shaft gearbox. With the belt drives, the total ratio is 45:1 for the pitch axis and 42:1 for the rollers. Well, that's it for now. I feel like I'm finally ready to build something more complex in the next project. What do you think? How do you like this drive and would you use it in your own build? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe and check out my Instagram. Thanks for watching.